Hey you, and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry. In this whole video, I want to let you know that I have my new classes starting here in January, and we'll be meeting every Tuesday at 4 o'clock p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And I'll actually be doing a live presentation during that time. If you want to register for that free computer class, all you have to do is, in the description, click on the link that I'll have down there to join the class, and it's a free class, so hey, why not? Also, let's say that you want to see it at any time, I have it as a playlist. So if you look above me there, there's a link there. You just click on there and you can actually see the playlist and then play any of the lessons that you want to. Now, what do I cover? Well, in the computer literacy course, I go over using your Windows machine, your Chromebook, as well as working with your cell phones. I start with the very basics, and then from there I go to using different applications and basically getting the most out of your computer. Also, you even talk about security and other issues that are really important for using your computer systems. I also go over Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, and PowerPoint, as well as Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides. So please click on the thumbs up, comment down below, because I love to read your comments, and share the video, as that really helps the channel. Now, before we go, I'm going to leave you with a really good informative video on some of the big changes that are happening within our Google Drive. So let's watch that. Selma Teaches 7, Mr. Barry here. Today we're going to be looking into Google Photos and some of the upcoming changes that Google has for us. Now, these changes affect the storage within Google Photos, but it also affects your Google Drive and even in your Gmail. So let's look at some of these changes, you and I. Come on. Our story begins back in May the 28th, 2015, where? Within your Google account. Back then, Google released Google Photos. And Google Photos was popular for giving users free, unlimited storage of photos up to 16 megapixels and high resolution videos as up to 1080p resolution. Now, there was no limit on how many images or videos you can actually upload, so everything was free and unlimited. It was great. And the service automatically would go in and analyze all of your photos and videos, identifying certain things such as who was in them, visual features, and subjects. This allowed the users to keep their videos and photos private, yet allowed them to go in and search by person, item, place, or even date. And for over 5 years, users were uploading images and videos. In fact, as of November 2020, over 4 trillion photos and videos have been uploaded to the service. But Google has announced something. They announced starting June the 1st, 2021, all that changes. What used to be free unlimited is now going down to 15 gigabytes. So again, starting June the 1st, 2021, all new photos and videos that are uploaded will now count against that 15 gigs of free Google storage that you have that goes in with your Google Drive, your Google Photos, and your Google Mail. Now, all photos and videos that you backed up, even in high quality, before June the 1st, 2021, do not count against that 15 gigs of limited storage. Now, all photos and videos that you backed up in high quality before June the 1st, 2021 are exempt from this change and will not count towards your Google account storage. So this includes all of your Google Photos and your video content. So the question is, do you need to do something right now? The answer is no. You can continue using Google Photos just as you've always done before. But after June 1st, 2021, Google will reach out and send you reminders when you are approaching that 15 gigabyte limit. According to Google, most users will have years before they need to take any action or before they get anywhere close to that 15 gigabyte limit. Now the next question is, well, when will you reach that 15 gigabyte limit of storage? And the good thing is that Google has created a personalized estimate that actually shows you how much time it will take before you've actually reached those limits. That estimate actually takes into account how frequently you back up your photos, your videos, and other content to within your Google account. Now, is there a way to actually check how much storage you have right now inside your Google account? Yes, there is. In fact, I'm putting the link right here in front of me, so it'll be right there. And I'll also have a link down in my description. You click that and it opens up to what's called Google One Storage. Now, the Google One will open up and you can actually go in, click on storage, and it actually shows you which items are taking up storage, such as your Google Drive, your Gmail, as well as your Google Photos. Now, that's not the end to the changes. Another feature that's actually coming up with Google Photos is an easy way to delete extra or duplicated images, or images that are maybe too dark or blurry. So it allows you to take those out, and those will not be counting against your storage. Of course, that applies to the images and videos that you upload after June the 1st, 2021. Another question that comes up is, well, what happens if I actually do use up 15 gigs of my storage? What can I do now? Well, Google is offering low-cost plans where a person can actually pay a few dollars, anywhere from a few dollars to more, for extra storage. Now, another thing that you could do too is store only what you need in your Google Photos, and you can store others within a thumb drive or within machines that you actually have locally with you. And the truth of the matter is, it really breaks my heart, because I've been using Google Photos to store all of my images and to store all of my videos from my family, from my events, everything else that goes on basically gets stored in Google Photos. So when they say the average user will take years before they reach that 15 gig limit, I'm looking and thinking, wow, I'll probably reach that limit within a few months or so, or maybe even sooner. So the skinny part of this story is Google Photos won't be free any longer once you reach that limit. You do have some choices of perhaps taking out other images and actually reclaiming some of that storage, or you can go in and buy the storage and upgrade to a larger storage for your Google Photos and videos. Hey, if you do have a question, just leave it down there in the comments and I'll try to get to it as soon as I can. And like I said, this is a big change for Google Photos and it does break my heart. Well, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, share the video so that others can know about these changes. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. And thank you again. Bye-bye.